Hello friends, so kamusta na kayo? So ngayon, gusto ko lang mag-hi and hello for the weekend. And sana okay kayong lahat at nasa maayos kayo na kalagayan ngayong weekend na to. So ayun lang, gusto ko lang makipagkwentuhan about what happened. So kung buntis pa ako ngayon, hindi na nasabi na ng doctor sa akin na I'm negative na. And nakakalungkot lang kasi sinabi ng doctor sa akin na nag-offer siya na kung gusto ko raw i-flash out kasi yung lahat raw na nasa tiyan ko, hindi pa raw naalis kaya lumalaki ang tiyan ko kasi yung mga namumuong dugo na galing doon sa pagbubuntis nandito pa raw sa tiyan ko. And tinatanong niya ako either iraraspa raw ako or kumbaga officially na i-cleaning raw yung tiyan ko or ano nga raw yung parang iinom ng gamot ganyan para malinisan yung tiyan. Kaya pala ako nagkakaroon ng mga bilbil sa tiyan kasi raw naiipon lang raw yung mga kumbaga nagpositive ako sa pregnancy, hindi raw nalilinisan yung tiyan ko talaga. And then naiipon raw dito sa tiyan yung lahat ng dumi na galing dun sa mga namuong dugo kaya ako nagkakaroon ng bilbil. Yun raw yun. And nag-offer siya na merong panglinis raw talaga ng sa bilbil sa tiyan para ma-cleanse or yung mga namumuong dugo sa loob na naiwanan nung parang parang higaan ng baby sa loob ng tiyan na womb, ipa-flush out raw nung gamot na yon. Yun ang sinabi ng doctor. And then sabi niya sa akin, obserbahan ko raw next month kung ano raw ang mangyayari. Kung magiging negative raw yung pregnancy test or anong mangyayari raw. Kasi makapal pa raw yung layer ng matris ko. Makapal pa raw siya. And then kahit na nawala na raw yung baby sa loob, yung matris raw okay siya at normal siya. Normal talaga yung matris. Wala raw problema, ganyan. Kung mayroon man raw sumasakit, siguro yun yung namumuong dugo talaga sa tiyan na hindi naaalis. Kaya araw ako nagkakaroon ng dysmenorrhea tuwing nagre-regla. Kasi yung mga dumi raw sa tiyan ko, sumasabay raw doon sa mga naipon na dati pa raw na nag-positive na ako, na bigla raw nakunan ako or na pregnancy bleeding. Yun ang sinabi niya. Tapos sabi ko sa kanya, pag-iisipan ko muna kung papasok ako sa ililinisin yung tiyan ko talaga. Kasi sabi niya, obserbahan mo kasi kung malaki, either ooperahan ka or i-cleanse yung tiyan mo. Kasi marami tayong option. And then, kung ma-cleanse yung tiyan mo, kung maalis yung mga dumi, may tendency na taon-taon ka na magbubuntis talaga. Kaya tinanong niya sa akin kung ilang taon na ako. And then sinabi ko na 38 na ako, magta 39 na ako. And then sinabi niya sa akin na dahil sa mga edad mo na ganyan, pag tumungtong ka na ng 40, 50 ganyan, malapit na yung menopausal. Sabi niya hanggang 55 lang yung menopausal talaga ng mga babae talaga. Swerte na lang kung aabot sila ng 60 years old na mabubuntis sila. Kung aabot sila ng 60 pataas, it means surrogate baby yun at hindi intercourse. Yun yung mga pinapasak na sa harap nila para lang magkaroon sila ng anak. Yun yung sinabi ng doktor. So sinabi ko, hindi ako nag-aabol na magkaroon ng anak, ganyan. Wala akong ano talaga. Pero sabi niya, sa tagal nyo na mag-asawa sa loob ng 17 years, sobrang nakakapanghinayang na ang tagal nyo na magkarelasyon, ang tagal nyo na mag-asawa, and nakabuo lang kayo ng dalawang anak na teenager na ngayon at hindi ka pa nag-birth control. Yun ang sinabi niya sa akin. Sabi niya, hindi ko alam, sabi niya, at yung nakausap kong doktor ay bago lang na doktor talaga, mga baguhan lang talaga na mga OB-GYN ni doktor talaga. And sabi niya, this is weird happening that you already meets 40 and you straight 17 years married with a one man and you have only two kids and two sons and you don't have any you even had a straight pregnancy. It's all a pregnancy bleeding. And I said to the doctor, it's the God's happen on what happened to me. I don't know what happened, but I did not force myself to do any abortion or anything. I did not take any medicine. Or if I see the pregnancy test is positive, I did not do anything inside the house. I did not stress myself. I did not go anywhere. And also, I'm not working. I'm straight housewife for 17 years and I did not go for friends or anyone. I did not talk to anyone. I'm still inside the house doing the housewife, cooking, cleaning like that. And I don't even go for bar hopping or anything, or I did not drink anything. I'm not alcoholic. I did not take the cigarettes or anything. I don't have a party into my life. I don't have anything and I don't have a social life. I'm still inside the house. And the doctors want to laugh at me and she smiled like, oh my God, you become 40 years old and you did not see what's outside world happening like that. And she want to laugh at me and it's kind of feel insult at me because I'm a straight housewife. I'm a faithful housewife. I know what's happening in the university, but I respect my husband. I know how's the boundary between me and my husband, and that's so insulting for me to do that and laughing with my checkup about fertility and OB-GYN. It's so insulting. When she laughed at me, I want to say something bad, but because I have my university issue and I know what's the feeling of being a parent or have a mother or father or grandfather or grandmother or lola, lolo, nanay, tatay, mommy, daddy. I know how's the feeling of being in the squatter area or being in the slaughter area or being with other peoples. That's why even she laughed at me with the insult. Love. I did not take anything to tell or talk or said bad words to her. Just listen to her and explain what happened to me. And I said to the doctor, I did not want to have a kids or family because I want to finish my study and I want to experience the university, a real university study without cheating. Or I did not use calculator to calculate my math subject or answering my test or quiz inside the school or any school. I go in the lots of public and private and university in Mindanao, and I respect what's the people's happening or what they're done to their life, and I respect all the people around me. Even those people is always insult me to what I am right now. I know I'm a martyr a wife, or I'm a martyr mommy, or ako yung ano talaga, yung nanay na lagi na lang nasa likod ng asawa ko, dahil hindi ako makapag-desisyon sa lahat ng hakbang na gusto kong gawin sa buhay ko. Alam mo yung sakit na yun, ang sakit na yan, naramdaman ko na yan sa lola ko, sa nanay, sa tatay ko, sa tita ko, sa tito ko, sa mga ka-relative namin. Hindi ako pwede mag-desisyon. I don't have any decision to my life, and I'm 40 years old now. I don't have any social life into my life for my entire marriage life for 17 years. And I go back to Mindanao for 20th century. I didn't have any happiness at all. If you ask me, if I go in other religion, yes, I go for other religion. I respect those religion. Two hands. I did not do or insult or doing or talk about any beliefs of other people. And I'm so scared of the karma. I'm scared of what God's doing to other people. And if I'm like a weird housewife, I don't want to go outside. I don't want to talk social life with other people. And then I stab their back because I want to be famous or have a name on what country or what place. That's what happening to me. If I'm my dear housewife right now, I know the feelings. When I go in the Mindanao, I know it. My neighbor laughed at me when they saw my YouTube and they said, oh my God, you are in Mindanao, you go with friends and you are a fame in school and you are the top grade and what happened to you? You are my dear housewife. And I said, I don't care. I don't have social life. I just go in the Mindanao to visit my mother, but the religion of my grandmother is a Catholic from Spain. And if there's happening about happening, yes, my grandmother is already MK Ultra in Mindanao, and they had a family in the refugee squatter area in Mindanao. And my grandmother said, I want to be proud, all of my grandson and granddaughter become a rich and proud and using their name in a good way, not in using other people's name to be fame. And that's what happened. That's my goals. If I'm my dear housewife or 40 years old having a baby, I don't want to have a baby. But the problem, I got pregnant and I did not go outside. All my kids is in one man. I did not go in other men. When my husband and me together for 17 years, I did not go in a neighbor house. I know what's the feeling of university when you're insulting me. If you know that I'm the top one, but you want give us a top zero. I know it. I know the feeling. Huh? Kasi alam natin kung sino bastard sa ating lahat. If I don't have long nose or long neck or skinny, I'm a fat, martyr housewife, hide in the house and scared of outside world with a social life, who cares about it? Who cares? I'm a targeted individuals with a voice to scout, with synthetic telepathy, mind control, how I know how's the boundary between bastard and the real family, because we are not a bastard. We are the real family with a sabotage because of our grandfather or grandmothers is already in the MK Ultra in Spain and refugee in the President Kennedy and US. That's what happened, and that's what happened in Germany. If you know what's the different about the war, or they take everything. If they get your country, they take your ladies, your kids, your opportunity, and your goals, and everything they take, and you become a homeless. And that's not happening to me, because even my husband doesn't give me the money for every month. I don't care about it. Just we pay for our rent and go the kids in the school, and we are not cheat, and we not go for a credit, or hindi kami nangungutang ng pagkain or numihingi sa kahit sinong tao. We pay for our tax, we pay for everything. My husband is go for other work for 17 years for find our foods in our table. So that's what happened. If I'm zero right now, what's happening? I don't know. If it's God do the reason or reason for God, I don't know. But if you had mind control with the voice to skull, you cannot control what's the life happening in the future. So yeah, just wanna share, friends, and take care always, because there's no safe place to all targeted individual out there.